Hey everybody, I'm Rick Beato, and today's Everything Music. It's What Makes a Song Great, episode 113. The artist is Elton John, and the song is Tiny Dancer. Coming up next. Before we go on, I want to remind you to subscribe to my channel. I'm almost at 3 million subscribers, and a lot of you are not subscribed. I can see it in my analytics, so just hit the red subscribe button. Tiny Dancer was off Elton John's 1971 release, Madman Across the Water. It was written by Elton and Bernie Taupin and produced by Gus Dudgeon. One of the reasons why I wanted to break down this song is because this has one of the best chorus melodies of any Elton John songs. Elton John is one of the finest melody writers. He writes these really interesting chord progressions that will generate these beautiful melodies, but chorus is incredible in this song. And that's saying a lot because so many of his songs have great choruses. Let's check out the beginning. Solo the vocals so you can hear the beautiful vocal quality he has here.
Blue jean baby, LA lady, seamstress for the band, pretty eyes, pirate smile, you marry a music man.
Now, it doesn't matter what Elton's singing about, really. He makes it sound so melancholy just with his delivery of the melody. But one of the first things to notice is the piano part, because it's so brilliant. It starts in C major, and then it goes to this A minor over C, and then it goes to F major, F add 9. This is a thing that was used by people like Elton John, piano players that understood about chord inversions, people that were pro songwriters. Let's listen from the top again. That's an A minor chord there over C. And then F add 9. And then his melody
blue jean
has that blues feel to it.
LA lady.
Blue jean baby. That's the third of the chord.
Blue jean baby.
Every time.
LA lady.
So it perfectly describes that chord change.
Seamstress for the band.
Then. Those two inverted chords not only add color, but they have movement back towards the tonic, right? So when you hear this, very strong move.
Pretty eyes.
Changes the melody a little bit.
Pirate smile.
Beautiful.
You marry a music man.
First inversion chord there. And then,
ballerina.
Then we start this walk, this F major over A. Right? Then F major.
Ballerina.
E minor 7. A minor 7, D7 over F sharp.
Dance.
So that whole progression there is F major to E minor 7, A minor 7 to D over F sharp, D7 over F sharp. I love that part there because instead of going D7 over F sharp to F major, which would be a really natural move, he goes D7 over F sharp down to F major over D, which is really D minor 7, and that leads to the walk up to E7, and then to A minor. Then he goes to G7 over B, first inversion chord.
Dancing in the
Here's
same.
A minor, listen. And then pedal steel enters. Let's check out the entrance of the pedal steel. That's B.J. Cole. He's going from C major to F major of C. Beautiful.
In my hand.
Then Then the whole band enters. So you have really unusual groove, right? Really kind of a busy bass and drum part. I love it. It's just grooving along. Listen. Put it in with a keyboard, listen.
And then tickets are for gone.
We also have the electric guitar that enters here. Listen to the electric guitar and the pedal steel together. Plain fills, single notes.
She just laughs.
Love it.
One of all is not that bad.
First inversion chord there.
Piano my hand.
A minor. D over F sharp. Interesting here, because what's going on? Check this out. Then. That's interesting there, because I believe Elton's playing D minor 7 while the bass is playing F. Listen.
It makes a stand.
I didn't even notice it. Choir enters.
She sings the song.
Here's the choir by itself. Listen. Like a gospel choir. Perfectly in tune. Let me bring those choir parts down to where they should be.
Looking on. She sings the song.
Okay, this is the real pre-chorus where it goes to A flat. Now, one thing I want to do is I want to solo the vocal just so you get a feel of what the Elton's vocal sounds like by itself. Listen.
Looking on, she sings the songs. The word she knows, the tune she hums.
A flat.
Oh, how I feel so real, lying here with no one near, only you. And you can hear me when I say softly, slowly.
Pre-chorus changes keys to A flat and goes to these really staccato chords. So A flat, B flat major, G minor 7, C minor, A flat for 2 bars, B flat for 2 bars. Then it goes to G7 over B, then G7 over D. And then, boom, right into the chorus.
But oh, how I feel so real, lying here, with no one near, only you. And you can hear me, when I say softly,
the steel.
Slowly.
The drums, cha-cha-cha-cha-cha, but everybody's kind of slowing down right there.
When I say
thank you. And then they pick it right back up. Listen.
You can hear me.
Oh, laying back. Wait, then. Then we're into the chorus. One of the reasons that Elton is such a great melody writer is because he understands chord inversions and how to sing the notes of the chord. And he doesn't sing the bass notes typically. He will play, if he's doing an inverted chord, he'll sing an other note of the chord with it. He just has a natural arranger's ear. Pre-chorus melody is just a textbook chord tone melody with some extra tension notes to give the melody interest, right? It starts in A flat, so it's third to the fifth, and then on the B flat chord, fourth to the fifth, and G minor, fourth to the fifth, third, second to the flat third of the C minor chord. Walks back down, and then sharp four to the fifth on A flat, third, sharp four, five, and then it goes fourth to the third on B flat. It gives that tension with the sus four, da da, then da da da. He goes up to the flat seven of the G7 over B, and then G to F, so the root of the flat seven when it goes to the G7 over D. So that is a perfectly written pre-chorus melody. Now, after 2 minutes and 33 seconds, we finally hit the first chorus. Now, in today's world, that obviously would never fly, but this is what makes this song so great, is that it makes you wait for the chorus.
Slowly, hold me close, I'm trying to dance.
Okay, there's a few things about the chorus that really make it incredibly great beyond the melody. Just arrangementally what's going on. So it starts F major to C over E, then down to D minor 7, then F major, C over E, and this right here. That's an A over G chord. Instead of going to A minor, he could have gone F major, C over E, and then to A minor, and that would have been really boring. That G over A, along with those, he plays those arpeggios like that. That just makes it so much more tense, makes the melody so much more beautiful there. Let me solo the piano so you can hear exactly what he's playing in this part. I play D minor 7. He actually plays just straight D minor on there when I solo the piano. Let me solo the acoustic guitar, the steel guitar, and the electric guitar. Listen. Great playing like this. I mean, that just puts me in a great mood. If I just put the piano in, and we don't even have the melody, which is absolute perfection. Just this with the piano, listen. Let's listen to the bass and drums in here. So we'll kind of get a little instrumental mix going on. Listen.
Mm-hmm.
love those drum fills. It goes right with the piano part perfectly. Okay, let's talk about the melody. Listen.
Slowly. Hold me close, I'm trying to dance.
One of the really unusual things about this melody is it has an octave right in the middle of it, right? It goes, hold me closer. You rarely hear that in a melody, an octave jump. Hold me closer, tiny dancer. That blues note there, the E flat, is just makes the melody so emotional, right? Here it is again, the chorus. And you get the double track vocals. Listen.
Hold me closer, tiny dancer. Count the headlights on the highway.
Also, there's so much space in the melody, too, right?
Hold me closer, tiny dancer.
For the fills.
Lay me down and she's a blending.
Fill there in the guitar. We also have Paul Buckmaster's string parts that enter there. I got to talk to Paul Buckmaster one time before he passed away. This is probably 2005. I tried to hire him to write strings on a record I was doing. I can't remember what record it was. And he said to me, he goes, you know, I like to write strings in low registers. So it's great if there's not a lot of instrumentation in there because I want them to speak. And this is a perfect example of that. This is really, his arrangements for pop music were just so good. Just a brilliant, brilliant string arranger. And the way that these fit in with the mix, listen.
Lay me down and she's so bland.
Next, we have the bridge.
Blue jean, baby, L.A. lady, seamstress for the band.
It just has a development of having the strings.
You marry a music man.
So rich. Oh.
Dancing in the sand.
Love it.
Oh, how it feels so real, lying here with no one near, only you, and you can hear me when I say softly, slowly. Hold me closer, tiny dancer.
That is a great fill there. Oh, so good. Right here, though. Blap-boom. Blap-boom. With the flams, it's very metal. It's so good. It's so good. That's the song. It's one of the greatest pop songs ever written and has one of the greatest choruses. And it takes 2 minutes and 33 seconds to get to the chorus. And the song is 6 minutes and 12 seconds long. I've been talking about attention span a lot lately in my videos. And you got to have an attention span to even wait for the chorus of this. But once you're there, it's amazing.